Hi, what's up guys? I am Shai Sheikh from Easy Tools. In this tutorial I will be demonstrating how to create this graphic using Inkscape. So let's get started. First we will open up the Inkscape. I will go to the files, document properties, bring it here. Here display units is set into millimeter, I will set to the pixels. As we can see here a page, I will turn it off, show page border. Now I will go to the view, make sure this is custom selected, zoom 101. Now first I will create a rectangle. To create that I will choose this create rectangles and squares. I will create a rectangle, this size looks better. Now as we can see here a node, I will bring this node downward, so I will bring it down 3 step, first, second, third. Select it, give it a gray color. I will bring this here. Select out of the graphic to deselect. Now again I will choose this create rectangles and squares. I will create a rectangle of this size which fits in this curve. I will bring this node upward, fully upward like this. Select it. I will make a little bit thinner, is looking too broad. To do that I will be holding shift in the keyboard and I will drag this in. This much look good. Give this graphic a light gray color. Select out of the graphic to deselect. Now again I will choose create rectangles and square. Now I will create a rectangle passing through this. What I will do here, snapping is on, I will turn it off, enable snapping. Now I will create a rectangle passing through this graphic. Select it, give it a gray color. Select out of the graphic to deselect. Now open up this menu, align and distribute objects. Now I will select this whole graphic, bring it up on center on horizontal like this. Now I will go to the path union. Now as we can see we have created the shape of the bottle. It's time to give this a classy effect. So let's give it a classy effect. Select out of the graphic to deselect. Now I will choose this create and edit text objects. I will write wine in capitals. Select it. Now open up this menu, font family. For word wine I will be using a font called stencils. It fits the graphic design and it look good. You can also use your of your own, which one you like. I will be using this. Apply. Now select out of the graphic to deselect. Again select this. I will write on. For word on I will be using a font called Vladimir Script. I will search in the view. Here it is. Apply. Cancel it. Select out of the graphic to deselect. Now what I will do, let's first bring this here in the middle. Now I will create this word select this word wine. I will bring this here. I will make it little bit bigger. To do that, I will be holding Ctrl and Shift in the keyboard. I will drag this down like this. This much is better. Now I will make it taller. To do that, I will be holding Shift in the keyboard and I will drag this upward. And I will make as big as the bottle size. This much is good. So this fits in this bottle size. Select out of the graphic to deselect. Now select this Bezier pen node. I will click it here. Bring this upward out of the graphic like this. Make sure this is parallel to the W. Select it, enter. Select this stroke path, stroke to path. Now by holding Shift in the keyboard, select this bottle path, difference path, break apart. Now by holding Shift, select this to deselect it. Now we will delete this part. Press delete to delete it. Now we will select this, bring it up here, make it bigger. To do that, I will be pressing Ctrl and Shift in keyboard. I will drag this down. Now I will make it this taller. To do that, I will be holding Shift in the keyboard and I will drag this upward like this. I will give it a color of white. Now select this, give it a dark black color. Select out of the graphic to deselect. Select this all, bring this here. Now again I will choose this create rectangles and squares. I will create a rectangle of this size, bottle size. I will bring this node 3 step downward, first, second, third. Select it, bring this down. Now select Bezier pen node, click it here. By pressing Ctrl in the keyboard, bring this stroke like this out of the graphic. Select, enter, select it, path, stroke to path. By holding Shift in the keyboard, I will select this path, difference path, break apart. Select out of the graphic to deselect everything. Now we can delete this portion. Press delete to delete it. I will bring this part here. Let's give it a white color. I will make a copy of it. To do that, I have to duplicate this. To duplicate, right click on the mouse, duplicate. Now I will flip this duplicated graphic vertically. So I will select this flip selected object vertically. By pressing Ctrl in the keyboard, I will drag this down here like this. Now first open up this menu, edit object color gradient. Now select this. By holding Shift in the keyboard, also select this down graphic. Under CYMK tab, at A we can see here the value is 100. We will give it a 15. As we can see here, our transparency in the graphic, this look better. Now again I will create a rectangle. I will choose this, create rectangles and square. I will now create of this size, bring this node upward to make a, select this, bring this down. Now I will select this bezier pen node, click it here. By holding control in the keyboard, I will bring this stroke out of the graphic. Select, enter, select this path, stroke to path. By holding shift in the keyboard, I will select this graphic path, difference, path, break apart. Select out of the graphic to deselect. Now we can delete this portion by pressing delete in the keyboard. I will bring this here like this. It's look too broad, so I will make it thinner. To do that, I will be holding shift in the keyboard and I will drag this in. This much is better. I will bring it up here, give it a white color. I will also duplicate this one. Right click, duplicate. By holding control in the keyboard, I will drag this down. By holding shift in the keyboard, I will select this up graphic. I will also give this a value of 15. Enter. Select out of the graphic to deselect. So that's how we can create this graphic. With any queries, let me know in the comments. And if you like my video, make sure to give a thumbs up. Thanks a lot guys for watching. See you in the next video.